I see you moving, baby, yeah.
And you're looking good.
Said you're looking fine.
Everything's gonna be alright.
With a groove, roll about 8 deep. Now what's my next move? Wait until nightfall so I can enjoy. System pump by 4 cheeks, running like a convoy. Roll to the front, kinda clatter, what a scene. Pulling up with Jodeci, blasting out for 15.
Don't
bump my ride, girl, see my gearing. Notice my grill, here comes a pointing and staring.
Everything, yeah.
Flicks on a dawn, parry on and laid back with my chicks. Mike is on the left of me, smooth as flipping. Tricky and my wedding on the dance floor ripping. Tickets with a cutie, the key, I'm trying to find him. Tim is in the front and Mo Better's right behind him. And me, I'm just laying on the ground.
Oh, man. What's good, people? You know, out here in lovely Vegas. I ain't gonna lie to you, man. I ain't no Vegas get this damn cold, man. It's cold as shit out here, man. I'm like desert extreme out here. This shit is to the extreme. Like, god damn. I'm coming out of Colorado mountains and shit. Like, I get to Vegas, gonna be nice and warm. And yeah, that's a double negative on that one. But yeah, man, just checking in. Just watching some of the, I guess you can say, drama, baby drama going on, I guess in the trucking YouTube, which I know, I knew it was going to come back around. It's like, we'll have this thing of, I guess, the top YouTube truckers, whatever, it'll be like a thing of peace for a minute, then it always comes back around, like, oh, shit's getting quiet, we got to start some shit. Or, you know, something pops off. Somebody said something about something. Somebody didn't like this or whatever. But it's just funny to me, man. But it's just weird sometimes, too. When, as far as, like, accountability, you know, just holding people accountable. Whether you're a subscriber to certain people or... It's just weird sometimes. Kind of scary, too. Because some of the subscribers are... I guess are they fans or just subscribers? But it's just funny how sometimes they'll go out of their way to, I guess, feel like they connected to the person that they're subscribed to, or like, for example, it can be, you could, so I've seen certain YouTubers hold up a vacuum, like just a vacuum, you know what I'm saying? And then there are people in their comments and be like, yo, what? I need a vacuum like that. I need to get that vacuum. And be like, nigga, they got this shit at Walmart. What are you, like, they can hold up a spoon. Man, that's the flyest spoon I have seen in my life. Like, wow. Or when you know you, like, really disagree with somebody, but you agree with them because you don't want to get, like, which I've seen, like, you agree with them because you don't want to get blocked from their page, or you kind of want to stay on their good side. That shit weird as hell to me. You know, for example, I seen, I guess, the current thing right now with whole, I guess, Trucker Brown and I guess the Rankins, the $8,000 or whatever that he dropped. And it looked like D-Rob was going to, you know, keep it to what it was. You know, it looked like he was going to stick by his, what he thought. You know what I'm saying? But the thing was, he didn't hold him accountable. It's like when, you know, TB kept asking him, like, yo, so if I come up to you and ask you for $8,000, you know what I'm saying, are you just going to give it to me? And the first D-Rob was like, yeah, it was some paperwork. Which anybody would do. If I walk up to you and just be like, let me hold 8,000 or let me hold 4,000, you gonna ask why and what you need it for. That's I mean, that's, that ain't no off the shelf money, especially if we're going into a business venture together. So yeah, I'm gonna ask for some paperwork. You don't walk up on nobody, but because it seemed like D-Rodge was trying, it seemed like, not saying it was, but it seemed like D-Rodge was trying to appease Trucker Brown by saying like, no, nah, he said, no, don't even work, no paperwork, no nothing. If I ask you for $4,000, you just gonna get, are you gonna give it to me? And he was like, no. See, that's what I mean. Like, nigga, I just told you I would give it to you if we're gonna go on business venture together. But I mean, that's what I would have stuck to. Like, nobody would do it. Nobody's gonna give you $4,000 just because you said, hey, let me hold $4,000. And then that whole thing with I guess you can say, well, nobody had it. Look, man. On something like that, if you say nobody had it, that means everybody. And if you didn't ask anybody, like, yo, let me hold, this is what I'm thinking of, and you brought people down there under the pretenses of, we're going to celebrate my birthday, and then you go back and say, well, I had to spend a whole $8,000. That's on you. I mean, that's just, I guess, my side of it, as far as in what I see. No judgment, but even me, man, like, if I say something and, you know, I expect to be held accountable for what I say. And if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I try my best not to contradict myself on a lot of things, man. And I again, another thing I don't like is when people, you know, they claim to be your friend and all that stuff like that. Your friends, I swear, your friends, if they're your real friends, they'll correct you when you're wrong, man. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with your friends, because they're actually looking out for you. You know what I'm saying? And you can't take it like, oh, that's the word. You know, these motherfuckers is hating on me. Like, nah, not really. They're actually looking out for you. And you got to realize, you're going to be wrong sometimes. But just like the craziness I see sometimes, like people defending their favorite YouTubers down to the bone, even like when they know their favorite YouTuber or whatever is probably wrong, you know, or they don't want to, I guess, get in, if there's a disagreement or something like that, and then they're just like, my bad, moderators are the new club security, you know, that should be tripping me out. They'll be in the live and somebody says something that the person hosting the live doesn't agree with, and you're like, yo, get them up out of here. You know what I'm saying? Get moderators, get on your jobs. Like, wait a minute, we don't get paid for this. I didn't fill out an application to be a moderator. How, like, it blows me. Yeah, I mean, it just, wow. But it is what it is, man. It's just, like I said, it's debate. I think another contradiction I heard was, you know, speaking or thinking with objectivity. I'm just like, okay, this is not going where he thinks this is gonna go. But my thing with that is, how can you say you gotta think with objectivity and not, you can't believe everything that's being told to you, but yet when some of your subscribers or a person objects to what you say and you try to shut them up and kick them, you know what I'm saying, try to kick them out or not, or block them or whatever, it's wild. But at the same,
is on the left of me, smooth as flipping. Tricky and Moet, I'm on the dance floor ripping. Sickness with a cutie, the key, I'm trying to find him. Tim is in the front, and Moet is right behind him. And me, I'm just laying on the prowl. God say what's up as the girls cry out. She grabbed her man, I think she tried to play him. My only thought was to step to the AM, cause I came to have a good time. And at the end of the night, no doubt.